Hey everybody, it's Jason Blaha here, and it's time for another Breakfast with Blaha. And today, having that for your yogurt, frozen cherries and almond butter. All right, let's talk about how the fitness industry creates hard gainers. And when I say that, I don't mean that it's done intentionally with malicious intent. Although the industry oftentimes does do things in a very predatory manner, I don't think this one is done intentional. Because again, if you're intentionally making sure that your people don't gain muscle, it's not helping you. But it's usually guys out there who are saying, look, we can use all these tools to make lean gains. All right? So anyone who's telling you that you can make purely lean gains in the gym, that in other words, you can gain large amounts of muscle without gaining any body fat. It's the opposite of bulking and cutting. Because with bulking and cutting, you gain weight, you gain body fat, then you trim the fat off. We know that that's really the only fast way to gain muscle. It's the only way it's going to happen. So you have all these people who tell guys, look, we can use these different tools to minimize fat gain. Or they have them really focus on trying to get and stay lean all the time. And well, that creates hard gainers because there's a couple different types of hard gainers. Number one, there's the appetite, right? Those who just can't eat enough, and that comprises a pretty big segment. Number two, there's psychologically created hard gainers. Psychologically created. And the industry creates those people because they try and tell them this. Now, a lot of times you'll have someone say, well, if that was true, then how do some of these people get such big followings? Well, that's the funny thing. They don't get followings based upon people getting results. I have numerous clients who have come from this background who fell for this. Right? They fell for it and followed a lot of these people. Maybe even bought programs from them. I've seen the same thing with people I've done just regular my consultations with, because I do probably two a month of those one-off consultations where a follower pays me via our video call. We discuss their goals, helping them get there, and they move on. They're not clients. And I've heard similar stories from a lot of those people. They buy into what these people are saying. And these people oftentimes have a million or more followers. But that's the thing in the fitness world these days. You can get a million followers on YouTube, you can get a million followers on Instagram through really good marketing, right? That's it. Marketing, image, ripped guy who seems to know what he's talking about. Okay, done consistently and marketed to people's false ideas, because that's what people like. People have certain things that they want. And you lie to them and tell them they can have it and give them a way to try to get what they can't really have, they'll fall for it. And a lot of guys these days, because this image is created, see these really shredded guys and they say, hey, I want to look like that. Right? Fair play. But then these guys are lying about how they got there. They're lying about how they got there, especially if they have any muscle mass. They bulked and cut. Or they use significant amounts of stuff. And you guys know what stuff is. To facilitate doing that, and then they sell their methods. Well, what sort of methods are the problem? A lot of these methods are weight loss methods, right? They are tools that are used to help overweight people lose weight. Things like intermittent fasting. It's going to limit your muscle growth big time. Going to limit your muscle growth. Eating only high satiety foods. Right? I mean, literally, I've seen Athlean X, a perfect example. So him in a video before suggest, oh, if you're hungry, this is one of the way I keep my body fat lean. Sometimes if I'm hungry and I need a meal, I just have a protein shake. Again, high satiety, high thermic effect. The stuff that we would do is a strategy to lose weight. what's teaching these guys to think this way, and it's teaching them to think in a fat loss manner at all times. And fat loss really means weight loss. Okay, because again, bulking and cutting. It means bulking and cutting. So usually fat loss comes from losing body weight. Muscle gain comes from gaining body weight. Recomposition is not particularly easy. Doing both concurrently, and again, I've done videos explaining the sliding scale there. I may need to cover that again. But there are multiple factors involved on a sliding scale as to how possible recomposition is for you, and if those things push to a certain level for you as a person. And again, those biggest factors are training, age, what your current body fat is now, how natural you are. If they reach a certain threshold, recomposition becomes impossible. Okay, and it becomes impossible quicker than people realize. But they're in a fat loss mindset all the time. And that's a perfect one, eating lots and lots and lots of protein. Or placing meals with just protein. Doing intermittent fasting. Again, tools that will limit your calories. It will help you keep your calories in versus calories out in a situation where it's easier to lose weight. Well, you're not gaining muscle in that environment. And again, pushing the whole lean gains thing, telling guys, hey, it's possible for you, you know, to gain over time as a novice or whatever, 15 pounds of muscle with no fat gain. Really? That is a long process. And person is willing to bulk, novice can gain that in their first 6 to 8 months in the gym of muscle mass. They'll have to gain more than 15 pounds of body weight. And you can always diet it off. But to try to gain 15 pounds of it while staying the same body weight is actually probably impossible unless you're fat. And if even then, how long is that going to take? 3 years, 5 years, versus 6 to 8 months. And that's assuming it happens at all. Telling guys who are already lean, they can purely lean bulk. Okay? That doesn't happen either. You see plenty of experts out there who are jacked. They obviously do lift. I've seen Dr. Mike Israetel, perfect example, explain that lean gains is a myth. It's a myth. It's marketing. It's not real. Put on 15 pounds of muscle as a skinny guy and gain only muscle in a reasonable time frame, it's not going to happen. You're going to have to gain some body fat to get there, to keep your body in that anabolic mode. Doesn't mean you have to gain 30 pounds of fat to do it. No one's saying that. But you might have to gain 10 or 15. And then you lose it. But if people are in this mindset all the time, and they're focused on fat loss foods, right? Again, the whole ultra healthy all the time. Well, that's going to limit muscle growth. Again, if healthy is defined by being very high fiber, high satiation, right? High fiber, high protein diet, in which calories are limited. If you're eating like that all the time, you are going to struggle to gain muscle mass, at least drug-free. So hard gainers are being created with their mindset. It's the way that they eat, and it's the fear of gaining body fat. But they've been told that fear is okay because they don't have to. Right? So these are hard gainers that are created. They're not because they have an appetite issue. All right, guys, but that's really all I have to say on that today. I hope it's been informative, and I will talk to you guys next time.